Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. With me right now is Dr. Seth Lederman, CEO at Tonix Pharmaceuticals. Seth, good to see you as always. How are you today?
Great. Thank you for having me on, Christine.
Of course, Seth. Exciting news to get to today. Let's first start off with the fact that earlier this week, you announced that you've achieved 50% enrollment on your rally study to treat fibromyalgia. Tell us more about that.
It was an exciting announcement for us. The rally study is our second phase three study for TNX-102SL in fibromyalgia. So this study is really the only thing standing between us and filing the new drug application or the NDA. We announced the positive results of the first phase three study in December of last year, and we had been enrolling the rally study even during that time. We started enrolling in September. So we're delighted that now the first 50% of patients have been enrolled. And that has particular significance because we are doing an interim analysis. And this first 50% of the volunteers for the rally study is the cohort that will be analyzed at the interim analysis. So we've guided that the interim analysis will be conducted in the third quarter. And the interim analysis has four potential outcomes. One is to stop for success. The next is to continue as planned and just enroll the 670 patients that we're planning to enroll. There's another option to add more patients, which is a good option because that means that if we're close, but we want to be more sure of winning, we can add more patients to the study. And then finally, there is a potential for a futility stop, but since we just had a successful phase three study with essentially the same design, we think that that's a low risk. So it's a big announcement for us because I think it really allows people to set their calendars for Q3 top line. It's a 14-week study. So 14 weeks from, let's call it the 13th of March is when the last patients will finish. And then we would need 4 to 6 weeks to clean up the data, lock the database, and report to the interim committee to find out how we're doing. Now, the interim committee is just that, the interim. The top line results of this study are expected before the end of the year. So I think that this is it's our lead program. We are mid phase three, one successful phase three study. This study is basically identical to the last one, just some more patients, and it'll be transformative for the company. You may remember fibromyalgia is 10 million United States adults. Our tablet is taken every night at bedtime for chronic long-term dosing. And fibromyalgia patients, more than half of them are dissatisfied with their medical regimen. In the phase three study we reported broad activity, broad spectrum activity across a range of fibromyalgia symptoms and very promising tolerability. So we're very excited about this product. We think it's a valuable addition to the pharmacopoeia, to the armamentarium of medicines we have to control fibromyalgia, and it will be a big win for patients with success on this.
And just really quickly, exactly how many patients do you hope to enroll?
In this study, the total number we're targeting is 670. In the successful phase three study that we reported in December, it was 470. So the way the clinical trials work, by adding 200 patients, we've done, we've increased our chances of winning. And also with approximately 335 patients in the interim cohort, I would say we have some chance of actually even winning at the interim cohort.
Great. Thanks very much. And just pivoting now to your full year results, which you recently announced as well. Notably, you ended the, you've raised $77.1 million, which you'll use throughout the year. Is this enough? Is this enough to take you through all these various trials that you have going on?
So the so we finished 2020 with $77 million. And then in 2021, in two separate offerings, we've raised a gross of $110 million. So we are in a good cash position to fund our ambitious plans for 2021. So, you know, but I think that also importantly, the 10K shows the advances that we've made across the pipeline. We, as we just discussed, we've made big advances in our fibromyalgia program, which is our lead program, advances in our vaccine program, our COVID vaccine, TNX-1800. But we also have a number of phase two studies that we expect to start this year. TNX-1300 for cocaine intoxication. It's an antidote for cocaine intoxication. TNX-1900 for migraine headache. And also TNX-601CR, which is a new treatment for depression. So we have a lot going on. And I thought that 10K really documented a very successful 2020. And with the cash that we've raised already in 2021, I think we're off on a great start for a big year.
Are you anticipating to raise more?
We don't really guide on our future financing plans. I think in the history of the company, we've been opportunistic. The two rounds that we've done in 2021, the first was at 80 cents per share, and the second was at $1.20 per share. So, you know, we certainly, you know, liked that trajectory and, you know, building shareholder value.
Dr. Lederman, always great to see you. Thanks again.
Thank you, Christine.